Welcome to Fragrance Facts, where I give you truthful and tested details on a fragrance so you can learn more about it. My name is Marcus, and this is my review of Blue Jeans by Versace. This is a 1994 composition. It's an aromatic fougère. It's composed by Jean-Pierre Betoir, and it's an eau de toilette. So this is a pretty old release, but it's gained some hype in the community because of Jeremy Fragrance. He's saying that this is a powerful, long-lasting cheapie, and I'll let you know what I think about that. But we're gonna start off by describing the scent, and in the top, what you're gonna get is this soapy citrus and juniper with a lavender, vanilla, jasmine, heliotrope florals, and this basil, anise, rosy woods. It's gonna be citrus, soapy, powdery florals, herbal, and rosy woody. In the mid, you're gonna get this lavender, vanilla, carnation, jasmine, heliotrope, and geranium florals with this herbal sage and a polished sandal woods with a touch of coniferous fir. It's gonna have this forest woods vibe. It's gonna be soapy, powdery, floral, herbal, woody, and coniferous. And in the base, it's gonna be a smooth, creamy, sweet vanilla, amber tonka bean, a light, musky, powdery iris, and earthy patchouli. It's sweet, creamy, powdery, musky, and earthy. Let's discuss the performance for Blue Jeans. We're talking over an arm's length projection for 1.5 hours, and then it comes closer to the skin. It's a skin scent at 7 hours, and you're gonna be able to detect it off your skin up to 18 hours. In regards to the Saint-Siège whiff trail, it's gonna be a nice heavy push and cloud noticeable around you for 2 hours, and then from there, it's gonna lower down 9 hours total. So this is a solid performing scent, and it's a great cheapie buy if you shop it around, and it's a good old release. However, does it actually smell good is the main question, because Jeremy is right, the performance is there. But before I give you that answer, let's break down the scent DNA profile a bit more in details. We're gonna start off with the first point. This is a very, very synthetic and chemically fabricated scent. There's barely any naturals in here, and sometimes when you wear it, it'll give you a headache. The second point is this is a very powdery scent. So if you're not into powdery fragrances, you're not gonna enjoy this. The reason of the powderiness is due to the way that the jasmine, the heliotrope, and how the vanilla is created in this one. And just the overall global smell of this is gonna be this creamy, soapy, powdery scent within a citrus, floral, herbal, musky, and lightly woody, spicy frame. When it comes to the compliments, I get none, nothing. And the thing is, there's a reason why nobody was talking about this fragrance before Jeremy. The reason is, this is just an average smelling fragrance to forgettable. There's nothing fantastic about this release. And I don't know if Jeremy got paid by Versace to push this one, but all I can say is that this one is not worthy of the hype. I only think the people that should buy this are fans of those old school, old timer fragrances, and that don't mind that powderiness in their scents. Besides that, guys, I also personally have a nostalgic feelings to this release. I remember being 11 years old, and beside my camping, there was this flea market, and I remember seeing Versace Blue Jeans there. And I told myself, okay, I look at the price, $15. And I told myself, you know what? It's a Versace, I'm gonna buy it. And man, did I make a mistake. I remember smelling this and I did not like this at all. I was very disappointed and I barely wore it. And I learned a lesson that day, that it doesn't mean that you buy something because of the brand that it's gonna be good. Take the time, guys, to smell these fragrances before pulling the trigger, because you might be disappointed, just like I was when I bought this back in those days. And if we're to compare this aromatic fougère to other ones that were released in the 90s, guys, there's the all-star Jean-Paul Gaultier's Le Male. And I'm telling you right now, that crushes this any day of the week, and still today, you're gonna get way more compliments with that one than this one. So if you are looking into one of those old school aromatic fougères, Jean-Paul Gaultier's Le Male, hands down, guys, it's not even close. You could do a survey and ask people, everybody's gonna prefer Jean-Paul Gaultier's Le Male. So this fragrance, guys, is okay to me, even if I have nostalgic associations with it. But if it wouldn't be for that, it would probably be even lower in my esteem. But nowadays, I do wear this and still smell it and enjoy it once in a while, because it brings me that back to that time and a place and a specific moment in a time that I really enjoyed my youth. But there's also times I wear this and, man, it just doesn't work, and I get mixed results when I wear this one. Hopefully this review gave you information that can help you out. Take care. See you on the next one. Peace. Lights out.